Calvin Gaston at Northeastern Clinton Central School. It's the 12th day of February 2018. We've got our first points of the game on the scoreboard. It's going to send number 24, Hunter LaValle, to the line. For the Cougars, it's the Cougars and Saranac Lake Red Storm right here, right now. On viewer-supported hometown cable, first foul of the game is on Almond Sarkovich. Our referees were, forget, Barry Norton and Morgan Stanton. Temperature is probably in the upper 20s, right around 30 degrees. Forgot to take a look before I shut my vehicle off. Stepped on the line, says Mr. Martin. Adam Cater hollering out or whispering out instructions. Oh, nice feed, and it's popped in there by James Malinsky. A nice pass. See, on the floor for the Cougars, we see the O'Donnell boy, Ryan O'Donnell. Yep, going up there and dropped the basket. That's Logan Brown scoring, and the foul looked like it might be on Thomas Gilbo. It is indeed on Thomas Gilbo. Let's see. For the Cougars, we have 33, that's Robert Thompson, 24, Thomas Gilbo, 42, James Malinsky, 31, Ryan O'Donnell, and who's the other guy? Said 24. Two 24s? Oh, 44, okay. We'll just do so. 4-3 now in favor of the home team. O'Donnell back to do so. For the visitors, 15, that's Dylan Stewart. Blocking foul on Nate McCarthy. 25, as McCarthy's number 10. 25, James Catania. Catania, I think. Let's see, who else we got? 42, Jordan Moore. That'll be out of bounds. And 12, Carter Gagno. On the elbow. Nope. Throw it up to the path, and he lays it in. It's Gilbo. Excuse me, Duso. Lucas Duso. And don't stand up with it. Thompson gives to Duso. Oh, Gilbo. Gilbo and Duso. 44-24. I gotta wonder who's who. Stolen by Stewart. Top of the arc, it's rebounded. And we're gonna have a little foul. Well, we got 45, Aiden Kreller in. Places Thompson. 5 seconds to get it in. And come deep. To Stewart. I'm A nice job of getting through there by Gilbo. I'll make it 8-3 Cougars. We're at 4.5 here in the opening quarter. As I said, February 12th, 209 years ago, back in 1809, Abraham Lincoln was born. Basket by Stewart makes it 8-5, and we have a timeout on the floor with 4:15 on the clock. Rebounded. O'Donnell throws it up after getting the ball from Gilbo and tosses it in. 10-5 now, Cougars. This game was rescheduled from earlier in the season. Shot up to 3-pointer number 10. Yep, that's number 10, McCarthy. Makes it 10-8. All we got on the line. Just so they're inbound. Rebounded by Stewart. Oh, and Stewart was Catania. Run by Malinsky, and we have a jump ball. Red ball. No foul. Malinsky rebounds. Taken back by Daniel. Rebounded by Gilbo. And Malinsky is fouled. Foul will be on Daniel. He spells his Daniel the old-fashioned way. G-A-G-N-O-N, often referred to as Gagnon, but it's Gagnon. As generations came down, as other people pronounced their names, they started to live with the mispronunciations. And of course, some people, just so their name would be pronounced right, change the spelling, like our G-O-N-Y-O's that we have here, Gagno. Top of the three-pointer. We have the number 20, Alman Sokovic in, back in, I should say, for the Storm. Oop, follow your shot. Gilbo took the shot, didn't follow it. So then admired it, and it came right back to where he could have been if he'd followed the shot. Jump ball. 1:13 on the clock, 12-8 the score. I can see the scoreboard tonight. Normally, whoever raises that backboard only raises it about this high, and all I can see is the, I'm lucky the score, not the time, but they can see the time too, so. Although we raised it up, keep doing it. Neither team wants it, so we're back, temporarily back to the Cougars. .55 on the clock. And that's what's good by Moore, Jordan Moore. And it's a 1-point game with 49.9 showing. The regular season is wrapping up this week. Nice feed laid in there by Crawler. So I know the Cougars have a home game tomorrow night, their last home game. Not sure if they have a road game after this, so these teams might have one, no more than two games left in the season. 22 seconds to go in the first period. Point land, a little tight it. Line runs out. Oh, it's 14-11 Cougars at the end of one here on viewer supported local television hometown cable. Moore with the ball, passes it over to Murnane, back to Moore. And another foul, 10 seconds into the second quarter. Fouls on Hunter LaValle, his first, team third. Both teams with three fouls here in the first half so far. Ryan keeps it traveled. Red Storm pressing. Blocked by Moore. We'll take it away. The 23 is in, that's LaValle. In and out on the shot. And put back up and in. We'll do so with the original shot. Gilbo is going to go to the line. The basket will count. Was on number 33, Brown, as first, team fourth. Lobo Hutz. This is 17-11. Rebounded by Gilbo. And we're going to have a reach on Gagneau. That's his second foul. He's going to be replaced by McCarthy. All into Gilbo from LaValle. Slapped away by Moore. Stolen Ouch. Gilbo. Fouls on Stewart, his first, team sixth. Well, the Cougars will be shooting from here on in. Well, this is a shot. The next one to be the seventh foul, so it'll be no less than a 1-1. I'll make it 18-11. 6:08 to go in the first half. Roanoke Lake visiting Northeastern Clinton as the 2018 season winds down. Olympics going on. They got the Madster, Saranac Lake native, winning a gold medal in the luge. And of course, his father, Eddie Jr., is a student here. Early 70s, he went to St. Patrick's Elementary with my wife and then transferred over here to Champlain Central. I think he ended up graduating, Eddie ended up graduating from KI, I believe, class of 71. And his, Eddie's junior's father, Ed Sr., is my physics teacher at St. Mary's. Aunt Audra Mazda was a star athlete at Shazy Central. She graduated, I think, in 86 or 87. Well, the Mazdas are very familiar names here in the northern tier of Clinton County, but all from a generation ago. Rebound pulled down by McCarthy. Rebounded by Gilbo. Dussel up to Queller, and Queller puts it in. And we have a Saranac Lake timeout. 4:10 on the clock, they're down 20-11. Red Storm is yet to score here in the second quarter. They trailed 14-11 coming in. And the Cougars have scored 6 unanswered points thus far in the second period. Cougars in their 2-3 defense. And that leg trying to pass around. Count the basket. They'll send Stewart to the line. The foul was on Dusso, his first. Team fourth. And we got 12 back in. That's Gagno in replacing Monane. Nice job by Thomas Gilbo. 22-13, 3:33 to go in the quarter. Second quarter. Count it. That's goodbye Moore. Who's the foul on you? Gilbo is second. And O'Donnell's going to come in for him. Thank you. flipping the ball around. Left out of bounds by Moore. That one. .235 left and a half. Donald into the forecourt. Off the rim on the shot by LaValle. Basket by 15, that's Stewart. 22-17. 1:42 to go in the second quarter. O'Donnell, that's it in. 24-17, Cougars. 1:22 to go. Not exactly sure what the call was. Donald brings it up. And Stone takes it away. Moore with the ball. Under a minute to go in the half. Red ball being bounded by McCarthy. 44.9 on the game clock, 34 on the shot clock. Bumper. Off-white. So the shot clock will be off with 26 seconds left in half. Red Storm looking for the last shot, down to 14 seconds. The elbow banked in. Banked in, that wasn't what Moore was planning to do, but he said, hey, what the heck? I'll take it. Air ball. Block. So 24-19, Cougars up by 5 at the half here on viewer-supported local television hometown cable. Second half. Cougars with the ball. Rebounded by Brown. Whoop. Some lucked out on that one. You got to be careful when you're throwing the ball in underneath the other guy's basket. You don't hand them an easy 2 points. Three-pointer. Nothing but net. By number 44 in your program, Lucas Dussel. Hit the rim. Clock clock keeps ticking. That one didn't hit the rim either, but it hit the net from the inside. That's Stewart. 26-21. Rebounded by Sukovic. Out of bounds. Gilbo into the forecourt. Donald back to Gilbo. Over to Dussel. Another foul called on Stewart. First foul of the second half, 5:53 on the clock. Foul is on Brown. We have Catania and Gagnon for the Red Storm. Dussel shooting his second shot. That one goes in. 28-21, 7 point for the lead. Jump ball. Saranac Lake Stern. The pointer is no good. Rebound put back up and in. That was number 10, McCarthy. 28-23. Oh, double dribble on O'Donnell. One double dribble and you're out. What we got? You got LaValle and Kreller in. From way downtown. Five or two to go in the third quarter. 28-23 Cougars. Stolen away. And a layup is good. There's Jordan Moore in the steal and basket. Timeout for the Cougars. The lead is down to three with 4:48 showing in the third. Bring it up after getting it from LaValle. Back to LaValle for three. No. Apparently off of Moore. Daniel. Think he bumped his head. If he got a knee in the head, or if he hit his head in the floor, or what? Shaking it off. LaValle. Down by Tatnaya. Walensky gives Gilbo. Well, he goes back to Gilbo, he goes to Keller. And the storm comes out with it. This is Gagno. And a foul. Timeout. A triple three-bagger. Jordan Moore has just tied the game. 28-28, 3:46 to go in the third. And the storm takes it away. Save it up to Kreller. Kreller puts the Cougars back up. 3:20 on the clock in the third. 30-28 Northeastern. Way downtown. Oh, wow. Nothing but net on that one. The Red Storm in the lead. 31-30. And a steal, but not very long. Gilbo gets it back for the Cougars. Cougar fans are a little excited there. .234 showing. O'Donnell is in for Dusso. Storm turn on the possession arrow. 3 when the ball is inbounded. 31-30. Brian Blake leading for what could be the first time in the game. That'll be a foul on LaValle. Second team foul. And first team foul. His second. And he's replaced by Dusso. Lauren to Stewart. Nope, one foul. We're gone by Molesky. The other was fouled. Oh, 113 showing. The Cougar ball underneath. It's the third team foul. First foul on Katnea. Lobo. Hands it off. That is shot. Rebounded by McCarthy. Storm looking to add to their 1-point lead. No travel. More. Team will keep it. And Blake keeps the ball. Shot clock is off for some reason. I guess they called it a possession there with the Cougars. I don't know who keeps calling me here. We're using up my minutes. He gets the ball. Gilbo, 21 seconds. A lot of time left in the third. One shot. 14 seconds. Gilbo puts it in. Cougars lead. 4 seconds. More. For the Cougars. Back in the lead, they lead by one, 32-31 after three here on Viewer Sported Hometown Cable. Okay, fourth quarter is underway. Cougars have the ball. But the Storm takes it away. What do we got? All in 20, that'd be Sokovic. The second, team fourth. 32-31. Cougars up by a point. Travel. Oh, 3 seconds. 3 seconds. 3 second violation. Shot was taken by Catania. Put the ball. Oh, sound like a hit off from the end of somebody's fingers. And that hurts. It can hurt. Oh! Handed it to Duso. Crawler penetrates, rolls it up. Tries to keep it alive, he does. Crawler trapped it alive, tapped it to Malinsky, and Malinsky takes advantage of it by banking it in for a 34-31 Cougar lead. Another three-pointer went to Ty. Whoop! Where'd that hit? Surprised that wasn't called out of bounds. Off red. Cougars led by three at the end of the first, by five at the end of the second, and by one at the end of the third. 5:45 left in the game. They lead by three at the moment. This would tie it. That one in. And we're going to have a hold. Fowler had the ball. Timeout. Do so? What's he asking about fouls here? Good ball asking always Morgan Stanton about how many fouls. I'm not sure what that was all about. Look out. Five 15 left in the game. Oh, tipping inbounds. Crawler walked. Looked like he got pushed from behind as he was driving, and that forced him to pick up the offensive foul. Looked like from here that he was pushed into his foul. Is trouble. Four 27. O'Donnell with a shot. Rebounded by McCarthy. 3:53 left in the game. 3-point difference. Lost it. Lost it. And we got her 12 in Ganyo in for Sokovic. Sokovic. Short. Right in the hands of Tatnaya. And the Storm has scored, and they're down by a point. 3:18 to go. Lobster when the shot went up, but I didn't see who scored. Hello, reverse. We won that one. 36-33, under 3 to go. Rejected by Queller. Timeout for the Storm. For the tie. Jordan Moore has tied it up. It's 36-36. It's at least three baggers for him. And that is timeout for the Cougars. 2:32 to go. We're tied. Dusso will inbound it. The Gilbert. Gilbert will go to the line. He'll shoot two. Well, then Moore, his second. And Thomas Gilbert gets his team back up. Gilbert hits them both with a line drive and that second shot. 38-36, 2:21 to go in the game. So a jumper for the time. Nope. The off red. Dusso into Gilbert. 2:04 to go in the game. 38-36. Cougars up by a basket. Somehow, the Cougars ended up with that. Mahinsky missed the jumper. And Moore will bring it into the forecourt. And that'll be a foul. They'll send Cernak late to the line. Nope. Non-shooting. Non-shooting foul. Gilbert is third. Off red. .136 to go. 38-36 Cougars. The ball is stolen by McCarthy. You know, we're going to have, is it Moore going to the line? I think so. Foul was on Dusso, his third. Team fourth. Moore can tie it with the second one. 1:24 remaining. We're tied, 38-all. Could we be heading for overtime? Mahinsky has tied up, jump ball. Cougars turn on the possession arrow. 1:11, 23 on the shot clock. Five seconds to get it in. The final O'Donnell. Gilbert. Dusso. Further shot. Going in. Great effort there by Thomas Gilbert. Cernak late timeout. They're down by 2 with 55.4 to go. Red Storm ball. 3-pointer was going back. The lead that they had this year. Three. I believe it might be on Gagno. It's 1-1, eighth team foul. That is Gagno's fourth. Malinsky will shoot. His team is up by 2. If he makes them both, it'll be a 4.2 possession game, but he has to make the first one before he gets the second opportunity. And we got who's now? 20 in, that's Sirkovic. Remains a 2-point game. It was rebounded by Katanaya. For the lead, no, rattled it out. Moore gets it back with a steal. Timeout for the Storm. 16.6 on the clock. Red Storm trailed by 2. I'd want to shoot around the 10-second mark, give myself a chance for a rebound. They're running it down. Running it down, taking a chance on one shot. And it doesn't pay off. Took too much time. I would have shot that, give myself a chance for a second shot. They chose to hold it for the last shot. So a 48 victory for the Cougars. They defeat the Seneca Lake Red Storm, and that's the way it was in junior varsity boys basketball in this 12th day of February 2018. The ninth I'm thinking of is 1809 when Abe Lincoln was born. Thanks for watching and supporting. Viewer supporting local television, Hometown Cable. Win, lose, or draw, TV worthy of your support. Hometown Cable, thank you for watching.